Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the TSX top 10 volume leaders from Wednesday's trading action. Actually, this morning we're going to do the top 12. Let's start off this morning with Lundin Mining, and you can see the last time we had an early warning signal was back here. The chart started to turn red. We were expecting a potential hold of support at the October lows, and we tried that on Tuesday, but unfortunately on Wednesday we broke down. We're now seeing panic selling. We traded below 410 but actually held it, so that price target is still holding in place. That was the bottom of our projected trading range. We did break down below $4. We traded as low as 368 yesterday, and so $4 is no longer in play. Look for a move down to $3 if we take out yesterday's low. On the upside, we need to close on Thursday above 543. Of course, we're not expecting anything like that, and that upper channel line will continue to move lower daily. Next up is a very broken stock, Legacy Oil and Gas. I don't know the company, but I know the chart. If you see the blue across the bottom here, we have an elongated pressure zone right across the bottom of the screen. And so that tells us that this stock is broken. And of course, so does the price movement. Anytime you see a stock at $10 on the left top left-hand corner and down getting down towards a dollar on the right-hand corner, you know the stock is broken. So we're breaking down below 156. If you look, you can see our next price target is actually zero, which is not really that usable. We need some more price targets, some potential areas of support on the way down. And if we continue lower, we got as low as 117 yesterday. Of course, the big round number of $1 is a potential area of support. But mathematically speaking, take 156 divided by 2, 78 cents is a mathematical target. Then divide that by 2, and 39 cents is a mathematical target. So that's what you do when you have zero as your next target to the downside. Looking up, a close above 186 on Thursday would give us a buy signal for Legacy. Yamana Gold, an early warning signal there. We traded up into the open gap. I was expecting to be able to fill it. Unfortunately, that is not what this stock wants to do right now. And so we're back on a sell signal, as of Wednesday's close. We did see some downward pressure in some gold stocks on Wednesday. There are some individual stock stories there, but gold is up in the pre-market this morning, and that could help the gold sector. Next up, we're looking at Bombardier, and it was up nicely yesterday, back on a buy signal. A close below 397 would change that on Thursday. Of course, we're looking for a move back up to 440. That's where we peaked there. That's where we peaked back in the early part of the year. So if we can take out the downtrend line there, look for a move up to 440. Our next stock this morning is Pacific Rubiales, another broken stock, currently seeing panic selling. Our next mathematical target is 313, got as low as 335 yesterday. Of course, if we take out 313, then $3 is also a potential area of support. Looking up on Thursday, we need to close above 622 to generate a buy signal. TD Bank is our next stock, and we're back down at the October lows. If the $50 level doesn't hold, look for a move two lines down to 46.88, which would also be our next weekly target to the downside. Looking up on Thursday, we need to close above 53.68, and I certainly don't expect to see that happen. Citibank reported this morning, and they disappointed the market. Their shares are lower in the pre-market today, so look for additional pressure on the banking sector on Thursday. First Quantum, we're seeing panic selling there. Traded down below 10.94 yesterday, so look for 9.38. As our next potential target to the downside. And of course, $9 is a big round number. Looking up on Thursday, we need to close above 16.43, not expecting that to come into play. Next up, we're looking at BlackBerry. BlackBerry had a big move up yesterday, up nearly 30% on the TSX. In the pre-market this morning, we're down 16% and change, down $2. If I had anything to do with BlackBerry, if I was following this stock, if I was short this stock, if I was long this stock, I would do nothing on Thursday. Just wait and let the market calm down. Obviously, a major overreaction late in the day, so not a lot of shareholders participating. The news came out, so just short-term traders and short covering. I don't think it's a major turn for this stock, and I think over the next couple of days it will settle down, but I certainly wouldn't do anything on Thursday. Next up, we're looking at Penn West, and Penn West, you know, you look at a monthly chart. At one time, this was a $35 stock. Here we are down hitting towards 156. Low yesterday was 172. And so right down at the bottom of our projected trading range, a close above $2.26 on Thursday would give us a buy signal for Penn West. And I would certainly take any of these buy signals. If we get an upward move in energy prices, we could certainly see a quick recovery in some of these stocks. I'm not sure they're long-term investments at the moment, but they're certainly tradable opportunities. Canadian oil sands, again, we go back to a monthly chart. This was a $55 stock at one time. Looking to see if we can hold 625. On the upside, a close on Thursday above $8.95 would give us a new daily buy signal. A couple of bonus stocks, Manulife heading towards those October lows. On the upside on Thursday, a close above $21.78. And there's Teck. And of course, anything in the mining sector is getting killed right now. So seeing some panic selling in Teck down to the recent lows. If those lows are taken out, look for a move down to $9.38. On the upside on Thursday, a close above 1583 would give us a new buy signal for Teck. Certainly not expecting to see that happen. Okay, folks, that is all for Thursday morning. It's been a wild morning for the futures in the pre-market, but we do have gold and crude oil up, which might help the Canadian stock market on Thursday. The stock index futures are trading very close to unchanged at the moment, but they have been all over the place this morning. So it'll be interesting to see how the day finishes. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.